He could even keep the ones he cared about from dying.
The Ahsoka Show confirmed that Anakin Skywalker now has the power to save the ones that he loves from dying.
Wow.
One of the main reasons for Anakin's fall to the dark side in the prequels was to find the power to save Padme.
The dark side of the Force is a pathway to many abilities some consider to be unnatural.
Now, we know that he was unable to save Padme before she died of sadness, but the Ahsoka Show just confirmed that Anakin has learned this power and just saved his apprentice from death. So was Palpatine right? Also, how did Anakin achieve this power? Stick around till the end of this video to see how Anakin learned this new ability and how this affects all of Star Wars moving past the sequel trilogy. Smash a like on this video and let's break this all down. Anakin has now finally achieved the power that he was searching for his whole life. He just had to die first. People are always saying Star Wars...
It's like poetry, so that they rhyme.
And this might be the greatest example of that. The entire prequel trilogy is the fall of Anakin Skywalker to the dark side. After all this distrust with the Jedi and his Padawan Ahsoka Tano leaving the Jedi Order because she thought the Jedi way was not the way...
This is the way.
And Anakin's master, Obi-Wan, was more of a friend to him than a mentor. But it wasn't until Revenge of the Sith when Anakin began to have nightmares about Padme's death. He was searching for help from anybody, but the Jedi don't like attachments, so they weren't gonna help. So he finds his way to Sheev Palpatine. And Sheev, being the very generous, helpful man that he is, tells Anakin that there is a way to save the ones that you love. And this is definitely the last push that Anakin really needed to fall to the dark side. However, even after Anakin falls to the dark side and slaughters a bunch of younglings, he doesn't acquire this power. He actually rules over the galaxy as one of the most evil beings in the universe for over 22 years. And then he dies, sacrificing himself to save his son. And then, and only then, is when Anakin finally acquires this power to save the ones that he loves from death. Ironically, all it took was for Anakin himself to die for him to be able to save the ones that he loves from dying.
Ironic.
We see this in the Ahsoka Show. In episode 4, Ahsoka loses to Baylan Skoll in a lightsaber duel. She gets pushed off the cliff to her death. But Anakin puts this newfound ability to use and saves his Padawan, while also giving her one last lesson. Now, how did Anakin attain this crazy power that nobody else was able to accomplish? Well, this goes back to the prophecy of Anakin Skywalker being the Chosen One. Anakin was created by the Force itself, which is why he has no father, because he was created to be the father of the Force and keep the balance between the light side and the dark. It's also funny that when Anakin was alive for 44 years, 22 of them he spent on the light side and the other 22 he spent in the dark. Perfectly balanced, and after he dies, he becomes the keeper of that balance between the Force, giving him... which includes the ability to save the ones that you love from death. So although it was really cool to see Anakin in the Ahsoka Show, a lot of people missed that he finally got the power that Palpatine promised him all those years ago. Now, how does this affect Star Wars post-sequel trilogy? Well, Anakin just saved Ahsoka Tano. In the finale of the Ahsoka Show shows Sabine, Hu Yang, and Ahsoka staying on Peridia in this new galaxy far away from the original galaxy that we know and love. Meaning Ahsoka could play a major role in what happens in the Star Wars galaxy in a post-sequel world. Now you might be saying, Mike, Ahsoka has to be dead. She calls out to Rey in Rise of Skywalker. But that doesn't necessarily mean that she's dead. In episode 7 of the Ahsoka Show, when Hu Yang and Ahsoka first arrive to Peridia and are hiding in the ring around the planet, Ahsoka calls out to Sabine. Now, this is not the first time we've seen this happen in Star Wars. We saw it with Luke and Vader. We saw this with Luke and Leia. But this scene with Ahsoka in episode 7 confirms that Ahsoka does have that ability too, meaning she doesn't have to be dead to be calling out to Rey in Rise of Skywalker. So not only in a post-sequel world is Anakin Skywalker the keeper of the peace or the father of the Mortis gods, but he used his power to save the ones that he loves, to save his apprentice, Ahsoka Tano, and now she can have a huge impact on the Star Wars galaxy in a post-sequel world. But tell me what you think in the comment section below. Isn't it pretty cool that Anakin finally achieved the power that he's been searching for his entire life? The ability to save the ones that he loves from dying. And all it took was Anakin himself to die. Tell me what you think in the comments below. Smash a like on this video if you liked it. Hit subscribe and hit that bell so you get notified every time I post a video. We go live on this channel every Tuesday, Thursday, and Saturday. So don't miss out on any of that by hitting that subscribe. And if you want more, go check out this video I just did about why Anakin Skywalker doesn't show up in the sequel trilogy.